person who has at least B2 level of German has an edge over others, because you know Germany is a market which is huge. Actually, it's one of the third or fourth in the world, and the largest economy in Europe in most of the sectors. So I think, but the catch is you have to know the local language.
Hello everyone, greetings from Gururo. I'm Sneha, working in the customer success team. Today we will talk with one of our students about his journey with IU International University of Applied Sciences. This video will help you clarify all your queries about IU University and will also help you understand if you should enroll or not. Today we have Kiran Kumar, who enrolled with IU University through Gururo. Kiran has started his MBA in IT management in July this year. Kiran has been a consistent learner and has many university degrees under his belt. He is an alumni of IIM Bangalore and BITS Pilani. Talking about Kiran's experience, he has 19 plus years of experience and works as a principal solution architect in HCL software. Warm welcome, Kiran. Now let's hear Kiran's introduction in words. Okay.
Sure. Thank you, Sneha. Happy to be a part of this discussion, and I hope my my experience would actually throw some insights into this course and the partnership with Gururo for IU. So I'm an experienced professional. I work in information technology industry, and I've been working for the past 19 plus years. So my area of expertise has been, I've worked on diverse areas in IT, covering various domains and various technology stacks. So right from DevOps to big data analytics to IoT and pre-sales and telecom, etc. So currently I work as a principal solution architect. So my main responsibility is to drive the enterprise architecture of my group and help in the streamlined release of products of our particular group, which is called Industry Software Division in HCL Software. So I'm liking my job, and so far it's been 2 years in this company, and I think I love what I do at the moment. That's it from my end.
Okay. Thank you so much, Kiran, for the introduction and for taking the time to have this conversation with us. Now, let's start the conversation. So please help us with your thought process on pursuing an MBA degree. Why did you choose MBA?
Well, for me specifically, from my custom perspective, I'm kind of mid-senior professional in my company. And then along with my full-time education, I had a multitude of other courses which I did. So I span, my awareness is on various domains, but I wanted something which is, I always wanted to do an MBA outside India. So I was looking out for other options like US or Canada, but then considering my experience and my age, I think Europe proved to be a best option. And specifically when I was looking through on the net, I found IU to be the best option, specifically because I'm a working professional, and it has got great flexibility. And specifically because of my long-term career goals of living and working in Europe, I think, and with the blended mode of education option that it provides, I think that's very much what I wanted. So I think that's it. That's the reason I specifically wanted to do MBA, and from IU as well.
Okay, that's great. So you wanted MBA outside India, and also you thought that Europe was the best option for you. And also IU University, you have, I think, researched about it and you found it to be the best. That's great. So that makes me wonder, why did you select IU University specifically? Would you like to elaborate on that?
Sure. Like I mentioned, right, specifically for working professionals with at least 2+ or 5+ years of experience, MBA is something which gives you that insight of developing your personal your personal insight and skill sets and your personality other than your core domain in which you are working. So probably when you want to move up the ladder, MBA is definitely required. And then, like, when I was actually researching around doing MBA abroad, I mean, I've been liking European culture since, many years. Specifically, when I went through IU, I think I liked it very specific because it had a very flexible course structure and it was very apt for working professionals, and it had a blended mode, which very well suited me. As in, I can do a remote learning or off online for some time, and I can switch to on campus. So that's specifically which I wanted. So, you know, I instantly made a decision to join IU.
Okay, I understand. So you like its flexibility, and
That's right.
It can help you in your career.
That's right.
Okay. May I know, why did you select Germany and not any other country?
Well, most Indians prefer North America, but as I told, like, specifically, Germany has got, I think, a huge advantage or a huge edge in Europe. Specifically, I wanted to move to Europe. Long term, I wanted to live and work in Europe. And I think Germany is a country which has got a plethora of opportunities, specifically on any domain. So considering my domain, of experience and my education, and I wanted to pursue MBA, and considering other aspects which were very specific to me, I chose Germany specifically because I wanted to live and work there in the future.
Okay, so you wanted to move to Europe, and also you found that Germany has a huge load of opportunities for
that's right.
Okay, that's amazing. Now, can you let our viewers know, why did you select MBA from IU University?
Sure. So that comes back to the same thing. Like, you know, I think I would reiterate, I think I have already told this. So specifically because of the flexibility about the kind of blended mode of education. And in a long term, the degree in IU would actually help you to have a career within Germany. So that's the reason specifically I selected IU.
So you wanted a career, like, specifically?
Yeah. Okay.
That's amazing. So may we know, which specialization did you take and why did you choose that?
Yep. So I think it's always right to choose specialization in the field of your work experience. So I've been working for almost like 2 decades close to that in IT. So I decided, like, I would go ahead and choose information technology. Well, it covers a lot of aspects of your general management, but then also in second semester, you have elective where you can choose your degree, where you are actually learning your area of expertise, you know, your area of expertise. And obviously in the capstone project, you will also do your thesis and your project work on the same. So I actually wanted to build a career in Germany around this, based on my past experience. So that's the reason, like, you know, I thought it apt rather than choosing anything else. So that would make more meaning for me, probably.
Okay, so since it was your field of work and you were quite experienced in it, so you chose that specialization. Okay, so can you tell our viewers, what made you select Gururo as your partner to study with IU University?
Well, that's a question which is an interesting one. It happened like I wanted to study in Europe for quite some time, but I was looking out for various options pertaining to my current state of affair. I mean, like, you know, I wanted something in blended mode. I had come across various other partners, but then I chose Gururo specifically because, you know, it was very transparent, actually, in terms of what it promised. Secondly, like, I'd say that, like, the course fees which Gururo has to offer in among all the partners is the lowest. I mean, I actually know that it's the lowest. I mean, which is very attractive. I mean, I would say that it's kind of the scholarship which Gururo provides to any of the students is the lowest among all the partners, which is very attractive. And obviously there are other perks and benefits which I've been availing. For example, like I'm eligible for a dual degree from LSBU. So, if I were to directly enroll to the IU, I had to pay around 1,000 euros, no, probably around 800 euros, which Gururo gives as a compliment, which is very good. And of course, I had enrolled for it as such. And obviously, I also enrolled in an EMI option with a no-cost EMI, which was only possible with Gururo. Gururo assisted me in all the process of a no-cost EMI. So, and also, of course, like, you know, I have on in the course, I have options. Okay, there is one more package about LinkedIn Learning, which I got absolutely free of cost. I was able to enroll LinkedIn Learning right in the second month of my joining the course. And yeah, and I think the people are quite cool and good. My learning partner in Gururo has been very good. He has been very supportive. So I'm quite happy.
Okay, so yes, I completely agree with you that Gururo provides job assistance and placement support, free LSBU degree, which is worth Euro 800, and lowest fee with huge scholarship, fees in Indian currency with no hidden costs at all, then interest-free EMI options, extensive support throughout the course, hassle-free admission and onboarding process, world-class course free of cost, and of course, LinkedIn Learning premium access, then visa processing support, and the networking opportunities is also great.
Absolutely, so, yeah.
Okay. So that's amazing. So what did you like most about Gururo, which prompted you to go with us?
I think when I first talked to my, from the bottom of my heart, when I first talked to the course counselor and the program manager, I think it just touched me about the transparency. You know, there was nothing which is hidden or something, you know, under the carpet, etc. Very transparent and open. And of course, like, you know, the frequent follow-up, etc. while I was interested in the program, that really, you know, sounded an alarm in my mind that, yeah, I need to go with them, because, you know, there is absolutely very, you know, people are very transparent, and obviously, like, you know, I like transparency and straightforwardness. So, you know, I think it's I mean, they're quite they're very good partners, and very I think it's been an amazing journey till now.
Okay, so like you would say that the transparency was the main reason.
That's right.
It was very highlighted.
That's right.
So are you still in touch with your counselor from Gururo?
Well, yes, of course. My counselor has been Robin Singh. He was the first with whom I had interacted in the month of June. And he helped me in a hassle-free enrollment process. And I was, the offer letter got released on time and everything was in place. Of course, I was in touch with Mr. Sagar as well for certain queries. But all throughout the process, and even now, I'm in constant touch with Robin. So he has helped me a lot, actually. So I'm quite happy. I'm in touch with him every day.
Okay, that's great. So can you let our viewers know what were the eligibility criteria for your course, which is MBA in IT management?
Well, very specifically, it's pretty straightforward. The requirement of IU in general is for any MBA program per se is a bachelor's degree at a minimum level in any specialization. Plus, I think it's around a 2 years work experience. So these two were the main criteria to get enrolled for, and this was the time when I was enrolling. I think right now there is an English language or a German GOAT exam which is required since November. I'm not very sure, but then I had already submitted my IELTS results as well, where I got IELTS band 8. So that helped me in smooth onboarding. Actually, first two things are mandatory still now. But the last thing, I'm not sure. I think either IELTS or German GOAT exam results, are they still, is it mandate right now? I'm not sure, very sure about it. But then, like, you know, I think people can just give IELTS if it is. And then I think band 6 is also, they allow enrollment even for band 6. That's pretty easy.
Okay, that's amazing. So when did you exactly enroll in the program?
Well, I had started my application process in the month of May. I got the enrollment date in July. So in the last week of July, I enrolled for this program. Yeah, July 24th to be precise.
Okay, that's great. So you have completed around one semester?
Yeah, 2 months to go. Yeah.
Okay, so would you like to share how was your journey so far with IU University?
Well, as I mentioned, it's a self-paced program Okay, but there is a lot to offer in the IU campus, in the My Campus portal. You have online lectures through CourseFeed, which you can take, which you can register and take. It's like, as I mentioned, it is self-paced, so no one will prompt you, but one has to be proactive in going to the, in registering to the course and logging into the course feed where you can access Teams and also access the interactive live lectures. If you miss that, you have some of the recorded sessions, or else you can actually talk to the course professor on the Teams and post your questions, and they make sure that they get back to every student with the responses on the queries or on the doubts. So it has been quite good in terms of remote learning, or you know, learning online also. It has been quite good. It's quite a very decent program where you can learn at your own pace.
Okay.
But then you have to be on your time, like, you know, you have to be prompt, and of course, like, if you miss out some things, you can actually network with your peers on Teams, where you have the option to network with the peers around the world in your specialization or in your area. So that makes things very interactive. Professors also are also quite good. I've posted some of my queries where I've missed, and then they were prompt to respond to my queries. So it has been quite good. Yeah. And there are a lot of PPTs, PowerPoint presentations, mm-hmm. online lecture, recorded sessions and tutorials, and extra study material, which are also uploaded. So that makes it quite interesting. And, people would, stick on. I mean, would obviously feel interesting and to continue learning. Yeah.
Okay. So your journey so far has been
very good.
As it has a lot to offer.
That's right. Okay. Yeah.
So can you tell us if someone can do the program along with a job, like how comfortable it is for them, or like.
Definitely, as I mentioned, it can be done with the job. Of course, like, you know, working in India, long hours, etc., leaves very little time. But definitely, if one spends over the weekend, like, let's say 10 to 12 hours, or it depends, actually, you know, if one spends a decent amount of maybe 8 to 10 hours per week, the person can very well understand the concepts and write and clear the exams in one go. That would be the bare minimum, I'd say, because normally one ECTS in Germany is 30 hours. So when you say six subjects, so ideally like 180 hours of study. So probably you can decently learn in by spending 8 to 10 hours per over the weekend for 6 months and clear the exams, easily.
Okay. So if someone dedicates at least 8 to 10 hours per week, then
yeah. Enough. Yeah, it again depends on the person, but like for me, I think some people are sharp, so if they can minimum, mm-hmm. if you devote 5 to 6 hours also, that's enough, you know, depends on the person. So I'd say for me it is 8 hours over the weekend, so that will be decent enough to, you know, have a good understanding on the subject and clear the exams in one go. And of course, like, there is a good amount of flexibility. You need not clear, there is no compulsion that you need to clear the exam, final exam in one go. You'll be given 2 more chances. So there are 3 chances to clear the exam, which makes it even, you know, it's an icing on the cake. Like, you know, you get additional things. Usually no one gives 3 chances to clear the final exam, actually.
Okay.
At your own pace, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's great. How are the semesters exactly structured?
Well, it is exactly 6 months. So the day you start, the last day of the 6 month schedule, your semester ends. So your overall program ends. I registered for 90 ECTS MBA, 1.5 year MBA. So my program, my contract ends exactly in 1.5 year. But then, as I said, you can actually park some of the subjects and you can clear them going forward in the next sem. There is no compulsion that if I have 6 subjects in my first sem, I need to clear all of them. Well, you can actually prepare for 3 or 4, clear them. The rest too, you can park it and, you know, clear it in the next semester as well. While you work on your assignments and, you know, you upgrade your knowledge and, learning about the subject, you can park it and make it to the and you know, move those subjects, write those subjects in the second term. But well, like you have to complete your entire program within the contract timeline, 1.5 years. But then you are flexible enough to write your exams at your own pace. But then I'd say that not to leave anything too much at the end, because that will lead to unnecessary pressure at the end.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so basically procrastination should not be done.
That's right. Yeah. One has to be disciplined to clear it in the first go or as it goes, rather than procrastinate and think that it would be easy, etc. Well, it doesn't work because course is little elaborative, and I wouldn't say it is tough, but it is quite interesting. And you know, the score, the result, the pass mark to clear is also kind of, bar is a little high.
Okay. All right. So would you like to share how do you manage your studies?
Well, like I've been working from home since past 2 years. So weekends, I do spend good amount of time going through the course content, watching the videos, you know, the recorded videos, which I missed, etc. But usually after my work hours, when time permits, I actually do a binge watch of the videos which I missed, or go through the study material, or do my own learnings. Well, most of the things are very specific to the concept, so it will require some time to grasp and understand things. So I actually manage, mostly I do it on the weekend, but as I'm working from my home, I usually manage after my work hours sometimes. So
okay, so you usually like manage it during the weekend, right? Or like after your work hours?
Mostly during the weekend, but if I have some time, right, and I feel like I would be able to keep my mind going and learn or to complete a specific topic in a subject which I want to contain, complete it, then I'll do it on after my work hours in the weekday as well.
Okay. So how are the online classes going on?
Well, as I mentioned, the online classes are quite interesting, quite good, but one has to register in course feed for the specific sessions. If a person doesn't register, he'll not be able to attend or join the online classes. But not to worry, the recorded lessons are there, but not all the recorded lessons. Some of them are not there. But specifically, one has to be proactive and learn, go to the course curriculum, and register on the course feed for the online classes. It's been quite interesting. And then, as I mentioned, recorded lessons are obviously there, and you can go at your own pace and post your queries and then get answered. Probably, I think they take around 24 hours to get back the professors. So it's been quite good. Like, yeah.
Okay, so one has to be like really proactive during the
program. That's right. Yeah. I mean, I won't actually give a wrong picture, but you know, remote studies need yourself to be proactive, because you're not in a live class where someone is actually guiding you through. But then once you register over there, you will obviously be navigated to the next steps. You will actually navigate it through. So once you register for the course feed, the next sessions will pop up, and then you have to re-register. You have to register for the next sessions, and so on and so forth. So you know, it's quite self-explanatory, the navigation in the course feed to register for online classes. So it's quite interesting.
Okay, so that makes me wonder: do you have live classes with your professors? And if so, what's the schedule of the live classes?
Sure. Yeah, as I mentioned, the course feed allows you. There's a field called course feed. There you can register for the live classes, as I mentioned. So definitely, during the German working hours, like you know, our time in India, probably around the afternoon time, we have live classes specific to the subject. And every subject has live classes. I think 2 live classes per week for each of the subject. So you can register in the course feed. And as I mentioned, if you miss that as well, you can watch the recorded lessons, and you can post your queries or doubts in the Teams chat, and the professor will will respond as soon as possible.
Okay, so there are like 2 live classes per week.
That's right. Yeah, in most of the subjects. That's right. Yeah.
Okay. Have you given any exams? And if you have, then what's the examination process?
Sure. Yeah. In the first term, it's common. I have 6 subjects. I'm ready for exam for 3 of my subjects, but for the rest 3, I'm still in the process of, I've not yet completed the entire course walkthrough, but for three subjects, I will give the exam probably in next 2 weeks, probably the mid of December, around the end of December, but I'm through completing all the internal exams, which are mandatory. They're not actually evaluated, but it is mandatory to allow you to, register for the exam without completing those and getting a minimum of 80% in each of the online tests as a quizzes. You cannot actually be eligible for to write the exam. So I've completed for three subjects, and mm-hmm. I'll be registering for the exam in, as I mentioned, for three of them in the second or third week of December. For the rest three, the last three, I think I'll take it around January, where I would have walked through most of the course content, and when I feel that I'm confident enough to write and clear those exams as well.
Okay, so you haven't given any exams?
No, not yet. But I've given quizzes for the first three subjects, and I'm on my way to write the exams mm-hmm. in next 2 to 3 weeks from now.
So are the quizzes difficult? Like, is it easy or like what?
Well, they're above average, they're conceptual, but then the catch is you can write it, you can redo it as many times as possible, mm-hmm. unlimited number of times, and you have to score 80% to pass each quiz. So that makes it quite kind of not so easy, but you will get to learn the topic and things like that. So you are getting unlimited number of attempts to attempt each quiz and clear it. But you have to clear with 80% score for okay. each quiz. There are 10 quizzes for each of the subject, and mm-hmm. each quiz you have to get 80% to clear, and so that you can be eligible to write the final exam.
Okay. And how many questions are there in each quiz?
Each quiz you have roughly around 20 to 30 questions.
Mm-hmm.
And all of them are multiple choice. And once you complete the quiz, you will be evaluated. You will get a score. 80% if you don't get, you need to reattempt, but the questions change. So it covers broad range of concepts in the entire subject. So, if you don't clear in the first attempt, you will get a completely different set of questions in the next attempt. So they will make sure that, the same questions are not repeated.
Okay. All right. So what's your mode of studying? Is it online or blended or on campus?
Yeah, well, so I've committed to blended when I registered with Gururo. So I'm still committed to blended. So I would be going to the campus in due course of time. But at the moment, I'm doing online.
Okay. And why did you choose this mode? Like blended mode and not just online or on campus?
Well, the specific purpose of joining this program was a long-term perspective of mine to be able to live and work in Germany in mm-hmm. the future. So this blended mode gives me that option, because online learning doesn't count me to, stay there and work at a later point of time. So that's the reason I chose.
Okay.
For the blended mode, yeah.
Okay. So can you tell us what's your plan for studying in Germany? Like future plans?
Sure. So as I mentioned, like I wanted to live and work. So this mm-hmm. degree will help me to get a German full-time degree and then give me a work option to work there for some period of time. And then mm-hmm. Consequently, go forward from there. So mm-hmm. getting this degree would help me, would open the doors for, the German market. Probably to live and work there over a longer period of time. That has been my main motto since the beginning. That has been the main motto for me to join the course as such, actually.
Okay. And what kind of job will you be actually looking for?
So in Germany, people do encourage, it's usually in the degree of specialization you usually get a job. So my past experience has been in IT. I am doing an MBA in IT, so probably I would like to explore in the international IT companies or fintech companies, technology companies, etc., mid-sized international or startups in Germany. So, yeah, so it gives me a broad perspective into the German IT market. So, yeah.
Okay, and what do you think is the average salary you may get in Germany?
As I know, because I've lived and worked in Europe elsewhere and in Germany for some time, 5 years of experience usually gets around close to 50 to 60,000 euros as a gross salary. And it's a decent salary for 5 to 6 year or 5 to 10 years experience. So the rest over and above it again depends, like, you know, depends on the company, depends on the role, depends on the how the interview went through, and you know, depends on whether the recruiting company is able to offer you that salary. So I think 50 to 60,000 euros is a decent enough salary for a 5 to 10 years experienced person in any domain.
Okay. And do you need to learn German?
Yeah, that's kind of question which is grounded.
Okay.
People think that it's not, but well, I think a person who has at least B2 level of German has an edge over others, because, you know, Germany is a market which is huge. Actually, it's one of the, it's the fourth largest, I think third or fourth in the world, and the largest economy in Europe in most of the sectors. So I think, but the catch is you have to know the local language. So it's like, you know, when you're in Rome, you have to be like a Roman. So obviously, like, you know, with English we can sustain, but it'll be a hard time even for jobs. So, but if you have German, if you try to attempt and learn even at a mediocre level, I think you're an edge. And then, like, I think that will open wider doors of German job market. And of course, like, when you stay in Germany, right, everything you see from right from the time you get down, you everything is in German. So you can't just sustain with English. It's just impossible.
Yeah. And it will also help you reach higher positions.
That's right. Yeah, because you will have more trust, because Germans are people where they're very friendly, they're very open and honest and straightforward. They don't like sugar-coated words, etc., like, you know, it's typical other English cultures, etc. And they want you to work for them and not with them. So they trust you, they give something which, you know, which you are accountable for. And they, when once they have their trust, they will leave everything to you. And it's a long-term relationship. So, you know, they're quite very straightforward and honest people, sir. Yeah.
Okay. And how about your plan for accommodation in Germany? Do you have
I haven't decided that yet, but I think, I believe when I looked at the accommodation which IU gives, probably there would be something which they would help once we land over there or before actually going there. But I think I am interested in actually going to the Berlin campus, and because it's a huge, large city with a multicultural atmosphere, I think I'd be able to find out something over there. There are a lot of student accommodations, you know, around the city and downtown and outside as well. So I haven't yet thought, but probably I think it's not so difficult.
So you will mostly look for student accommodation.
That's right. Yeah. I'll look for a student accommodation, staying. Putting up with a group of people, you know, while I'm a student, because I'd be staying alone, living alone. So yeah, living. I'll be going on my own, like not with my family. So obviously, I'll look for a student accommodation. Yeah.
Okay. And how about the visa?
Visa, yeah. So I think 3 to 4 months before I need to apply, but I think the rules have changed right now. There is an APS which needs to be done, which is the new rule from Germany for international students outside EU. So I have yet to get that done, APS, which requires your educational evaluation and, of course, your language test results. As I mentioned, either your IELTS for English, at least a band 6, either in general or academic, either is fine, or in GOET exam, you need a A2 in order to qualify and get an APS certificate. And I think with the APS certificate and with your other required documents, I think mostly the visa, I think visa would be possible. I mean, it's normal. It's easy to get a visa. But of course, like, you know, I think Gururo would obviously support in this case, like, you know, for visa assistance.
Okay. And I would also like to ask you, when are you really planning to go to Germany?
Like, well, I do have during the second quarter of 2023 I would be eligible, and I would be moving to Germany at that time.
Okay. All right. You have answered a lot of questions. So lastly, I would like to say that what message would you like to give to all the students who are watching this session right now and are looking for enrollment in IU programs?
Sure. So my message would be simple, like anyone who is who actually has the zeal to do an MBA abroad. I think Gururo does provide a lot of opportunities. It's a partner with many number of universities, and specifically in Europe, it's one of the best partner with IU, with affordable fee structure, etc. And I believe, like, if anyone wants to go to Europe and wants to have these specific, I think flexibilities like learning in a blended way with affordable fee structure, learn at your own pace, and with all the scholarship kind of thing, I think Gururo is the best. Gururo along with IU, I'd say. And of course, Gururo has with many other institutions across Europe and rest of the world. And I believe, like, it's one of the best.
Okay.
I would say it's the best, actually, in terms of, learning and enrolling for the, for various universities, the Gururo platform.
Okay. All right. So before wrapping this session from Team Gururo, I would like to thank Mr. Kiran for joining us in such a short notice. We really appreciate the time you gave us for this discussion. And I'm very sure with such meaningful discussion, our future students will get much more value from this conversation. And also for the viewers, thank you for joining us. Team Gururo signing out for now. And let's meet in the next session. If you have any question, kindly reach out to us for free counseling.